on the air at 8. Our little girls and boys are gathered tonight to hear the sweet voices of...
Better man than I am, Gunga.
Oh, no, 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 Mammy, oh, Mammy, oh.
Evening, pardon me, ladies and gentlemen. This is Station OUCH of the New Writers Broadcasting Company, pardon me again, operating on a wavelength of 600 motorcycles by the authority of the Federal Prohibition Agents. The first number on the program for this evening will be rendered, meaning to be torn apart, by the Silent Dozen Orchestra. They will play as the opening selection, People Who Live in Glass Houses Shouldn't. There will be an interrupted vocal chorus sung by those famous entertainers, Pete and Repeat.
Station ICH, New York. We will now give you the correct time. When you hear the beautiful chime, it will be exactly 6 7/8 split seconds past 8 o'clock. Eastern Daylight Standard Railroad Western Mountain Central Time. Get ready now. Listen for the chime. Attention. Forward. Now. Mr. Sclablato will announce the next future. Feature.
It is now time, of course, for all the little girls and boys of our radio audience to get ready for bed. So Daddy Scarum will tell them one of his bedtime stories. Come, Daddy, Daddy Scarum.
Once upon a time, there was a little boy who wanted to hunt wild animals. Naughty boy. So he ran away from home and went to the jungles of Africa. As he entered the jungle, he came upon a lion and an elephant. They were fighting fiercely. The elephant wrapped his trunk around the king of beasts, lifted him high in the air, and dashed him to the ground with such force that there was blood for blocks around. Good night, children. Pleasant dreams.
This is Station BUNK, New York. We now take great pleasure in presenting to you Howell and Bellow, the silver-plated tenor and the gold-filled baritone, in a group of songs. The first number is a new one to our radio audience, this being the first time in any radio. It is entitled On the Road to Mandalay, Howl and Bellow. Ladies and gentlemen, owing to an S-O-U-S-E, there will be a slight pause in our program until somebody turns this record over.
This is still Station BUNK, New York. Now that the S-O-U-S-E is done away with, Professor Doolittle, the famous leader of the Philharmonic and Mouth Organ Players of America, has said that if you want beautiful singing, tune in on our station. We now hear Miss Laura Screechum, a beautiful soprano, in an aria from the opera La Bum. Come, Mary.
Go to it now.
Don't let it throw you, Nelly.
Station IOU. We now hook up 228 stations, including the Grand Central and all points west, on our Follow the Green Line network thus bringing to all United States the world-renowned Professor Doneater in an hour of famous recipes from Cook's Tours. This hour is sponsored by the Bicarbonate of Soda Corporation of America and Walla Walla. Professor Doneater's recipes are famous throughout the world and have been cooked in 17 different languages. He will now tell you how to broil stewed tripe. Professor Doneater.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen of the radio audience. Now please stand with both feet in front of you, please, here together. Raise your right arm above your head and your left arm above your head at an angle of 45 degrees, please. Deep breathe, deep breathe. Close your mouth and say, ah, with me. Now count with me again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
We now take it to the Uppercut Athletic Club, so in a second you will hear the voice of the bell and the sound of the announcer.
Here we are at the ringside. Now I'm going to turn the mic over to Philip McCann, who will tell you who's who and who's here.
Well, I'm glad to talk to you tonight, radio audience. I just want to mention a few of the celebrities that are here tonight. I see right in front of me is Mrs. Stan Kopovich, president of the Men's Children's Boy Scouts. And again, right in back of me, upon my soul, if it isn't Cross-Eyed Kelly, the famous gate crasher. You've heard of him, no doubt. And right over to the right there, those sorrowful boys, the crepe hangers, you know, Billy and Ernie, with big broad smiles, you know. And right next to them is Slim Andy, the notorious picket pocker. She's wearing a string of beans that is a present, I believe, from Barren Island or something.
Ah, there's the warning whistle. Now, in 15 minutes, you'll probably hear the bell. I want to describe these fighters to you. Now, there's a big, tall fellow with a lavender, an old boy. You should see his hair. This blonde, it's kind of brown. And he's tall, he's a little bit short at that. Ah, there we have the bell. The fighter's in the ring. He leads with his right. He's up, he's down, he's down, he's up. It's rather a slow fight. The fans are dissatisfied. It seems to be a waltzing match instead of a fight. Ah, the fans are singing for them to waltz. There's the bell. Ending the 25th and final round. We'll listen for the decisions. Well, now, as you probably distinctly heard, the little fella that I described to you lost by a neck. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we'll take you back to our studio.
We are back in the studio, and we take you now to the Blue Room of the Green Hotel, where you will be entertained by the Blah Blah Saloon Orchestra in bars of classical music. Shoot, Harry.
This concludes our entertainment for this evening and forever.